Welcome to the Blazor Stepper tutorial. Here, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Stepper component. The Blazor Stepper is a flexible component for navigating steps or stages in a web app process. It's highly customizable, offering different step types, orientations, and templates for smooth progression. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine and one of the IDs installed. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the Blazor WebAssembly application. Then provide the project name and location. I'll proceed to create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the default application is ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, check out the video linked in the above YouTube card. Now I will show you how to add Syncfusion Blazor Stepper component step by step. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. So, I open the NuGet package manager, switch to Browse tab, search for Syncfusion Blazor navigation package, and install with the latest version. Also install the latest version of Syncfusion Blazor themes to host the script and CSS files. After completing the installation, I navigate to the imports Razor file. Here I include the Syncfusion Blazor navigation namespace, allowing me to utilize the Blazor Stepper component within the pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Also, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service. The next important thing is I need to host the script and CSS for Stepper component. Therefore, let me navigate to the index.html file under the pages folder. I refer the script and CSS file form the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now everything is configured, let me proceed to add the Syncfusion Blazor Stepper component. For that, I need to open index.razor file. And here I define the Syncfusion Stepper component by replacing the default code. I need to display the 5 individual steps, so I define the 5 stepper step tags within the Blazor Stepper component. Let's run the example application. You can observe that the Syncfusion Stepper is rendered with 5 individual steps. Next, I will show you how to customize each stepper steps in Blazor Stepper component. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to add label and icons in stepper component. First, I set the label property in each individual stepper step. Additionally, I define the icon CSS property and assign appropriate class names to it. Now, within the style section, I will define a font face with the specific source path, naming its font family as default to access the required font icons at the application level. Subsequently, for those class names assigned to the icon CSS properties, I'll allocate the necessary content values to access the required font icons. If you want to refer to the content values for the icons, please check the documentation link provided in the description below. Look now, you can see the stepper rendered with label and icons. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I covered creating a Blazor WebAssembly app, installing NuGet packages, and implementing Syncfusion Stepper with customization. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.